Hello there. This is a quick video on some really handy keyboard shortcuts in QLab. These will save you a lot of time and a lot of fuss. So let's jump straight in. So here we are. I've got some cues in our file. I'm going to hit go on this one. And we've got this dance track. So I can pause this cue by hitting the left bracket. This is a pause function. And then I can play by pressing the right bracket. Left for the pause and right for play. This is great in just so you don't have to keep hitting escape to stop the cue. If we just want to pause it, talk, do something, make an amendment, and then hit go again, the left and right brackets are the one. If we're here and we need to add a new cue, maybe we want to add a new group. A handy keyboard shortcut for this one is Command and Zero, and that is adding a new group. Rather than clicking up here, we can just press Command and Zero, and we can press Command and Z to undo those. Next one, if we want to edit the cue title, one way is just double clicking and sort of moving through, or a keyboard shortcut is pressing Q. So then we're straight in and we can rename it how we want. So that's just pressing Q. If we want to change the duration of a cue, say for example I've got a fade cue here, I've clicked on it, I can change the duration or the action by clicking on it there or down the bottom here, or alternatively with it selected I can just press D for duration, change it, and there we are, I've changed it to 3 seconds, and then if I want to change it, press D when it's selected and go for 2.5, there we are, two and a half seconds. So that's a handy way of getting around that. If we want to add in a new fade cue, say for example, I'm here, I've got this cue selected, and I want to fade this, I can press Command and 7, and that inserts a new fade cue. I can then change the parameters of that fade cue. So Command and 7 for a new fade cue, and the target cue or track has to be selected for that one. Let's just get rid of those. Next up, let's say that we've got some lots of cues down here and the numbering has gone a little bit haywire because QLab's automatically generating these numbers and we don't really want cues 10, 10.5, 10.6 and all of that. So a way of sorting this is clicking on the first cue, scrolling down to the last cue and holding shift so they're all selected. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Command R for renumber. Now, we can choose what number we start at. I can start at 1, that makes sense, and how much each cue wants to go up incrementally. And 1 seems about right. We could do 0.5 if we want, but going up 1 at a time seems good to me. And then I'm going to click on renumber. And then we've renumbered the cues, so they're all in numerical order. If at any point when you're working, the numbering system is a bit complex and a bit messy, you can just do that highlight all, Command and R to renumber them. Next up, some handy keyboard shortcuts to help with navigating around QLab. This thing at the bottom is called the inspector window, and say we've got lots of cues but we can't really see them all. A way of hiding the inspector window is by holding Command and pressing I for inspector, and that just hides it, so we've got a bit of a better view of our cues. Again, Command and I to show it, Command and I to hide it. Speaking of space, let's say we want to go into full screen mode. So we can do this by holding shift, pressing Command and pressing F for full screen. And there we are, that maximizes the window of QLab. So we're using the full screen. And again, shift, Command and F to hide that. If we want to view the cue list and active cues over on the right hand side, or equally hide it, we can press Command and L, just like that, and that hides it. We can also click down here on the right hand side if we want to, but Command and L opens and closes that. Settings, you can click on the cog in the right hand corner down here, but a keyboard shortcut for this is Command and the left chevron or comma, and then that'll open and close. That's Command and comma slash left chevron to open and close that. When we're working in groups, it can get a bit fiddly when we're opening groups to see what's in them, etc. So a handy way of opening and closing the groups is by holding shift and pressing the left chevron or the right chevron. The right chevron opens it like that, so I'm holding shift and pressing right chevron and the full stop, or shift and the left chevron and comma to close it. So that's a really handy way just to open and close all of the groups that are available. There's a really handy list of menu shortcuts on the QLab website. I'm going to put that up on the screen now. If I were you, I would download this or print it off so you've got it with you just as you're getting to grips with these shortcuts and working your way around QLab. Hope that helps. Good luck. Thanks for watching. If this video helped you, please give it a like. Do check out these other videos and subscribe. And if you want to support what I do and the channel, you can click on the link in the video description. All the best.